This is Blender 4.5, and it's a bit like a magician's hat, but instead of rabbits, you pull out photorealistic dragons. It is a 3D modeling program, but you can even make amazing simulations and full movies with it. One Blender-made movie just won an Oscar this year. And, as you will see, it can do so much more, that is completely free for everyone and open source. You can not only download and play with it right now, but you can even modify the code to your liking, extend it, or create your own version entirely. And it just got a lot better. Also, it is my dream come true, I'll tell you why in a moment. Now, as many of you know, I am a bit partial to the rendering part of Blender. This is where images get computed, often by physics and with a technique called ray tracing. This is simulating rays of light to get you a beautiful photorealistic image. In 4.5, the ray tracing engine called Cycles has adaptive subdivision. This helps you refine geometry based on how close it is to the camera. The closer it is, the better the quality, of course. And the further away, the more you can get away with cutting some corners. Quite literally, in fact. So, what is that good for? Well, with adaptive subdivision, you can get these beautiful 3D displacement effects more efficiently. How much more efficiently? Well, hold on to your papers, fellow scholars, because it is 10 to 15 times faster, which is just incredible. You don't get that kind of speed up every day. Loving it. If you have a piece of geometry with a low polygon count that you wish to soup up a little, normal mapping can help you with that. Look, this is not high-resolution geometry, but it still looks fantastic. Also, in Blender 4.5, the bump filtering of normal maps was improved to preserve more detail near the edge of shadows. There are more improvements to bump maps as well. I don't know about you fellow scholars, but I could look at this all day, okay? And what is this? Dear fellow scholars, this is 2-Minute Papers with Dr. Károly Zsolnai Fehér. Yup, Cycles now supports custom scripted cameras using OSL, that is super cool, but normally, if not done properly, it can make your images a great deal more noisy. However, not here. Well done! Now, here's some AMD goodness. AMD devices now use HIP ray tracing hardware acceleration by default, which can improve render times on newer AMD GPUs by up to 30%. Yummy! More competition for Nvidia. That's a good thing. So, this is my dream come true, because Blender is so precious to me. I've spent many of my PhD years programming up computer graphics and AI systems and used Blender for years and years and made so many great memories. And now, I got an incredible honor. I cannot believe that this happened. I had the opportunity of announcing some of these features in the official Blender 4.5 announcement video. Thank you so much. Now, there is more. Due to threaded optimization and fast texture loading, the really fast EV renderer is also now up to twice as fast, depending on the scene. Blender now has a new volume shader and yummy! Look at that! This really warms my heart. Physically accurate functions are there to model the scattering of light. Super important for foggy and misty scenes. Also, if you put the camera really far from the scene with some objects bunched up, nothing wrong about that, right? Well, if you zoom in, this happens. Oof. Yes, this is one of the most annoying problems in all of computer graphics called Z-fighting, and we want none of that. They implemented an algorithm called reverse Z, making these numbers encoding distances more precise when they are near zero. That is, more precision closer to the camera. And it paid huge dividends. Finally, no more of this nonsense. This is so much better. They also improved the crowd favorite, Grease Pencil, a feature used to draw in 3D space. It has seen a lot of bug fixes and small improvements, but wait, in the 4.3 update, I noted that Grease Pencil now plays better with geometry nodes, which are used to create new kinds of geometry using logic. And now they play so well together that, look, in 4.5 there are new nodes where you can combine them together for incredible artistic effects. And their video editor, yes, it has a built-in video editor, is seeing some quality of life improvements like the sleep operator, where you can pull at a piece of content to position it correctly. You have to try it, and you won't want to live without it. And now, you can change the backend renderer from OpenGL to Vulkan. Finally! With that, you get faster everything. Blender loads up faster, editing geometry is faster, and sculpting also gets a bit more interactive with this. Make sure to give Vulkan a try. Just chuck in more than 40 million polygons into the scene and watch how it runs in real time. Beautiful. What a time to be alive! And don't start from scratch, there are plenty of tutorials and test scenes out there in the video description. Here you see me running the full DeepSeek AI model through Lambda GPU Cloud. 671 billion parameters, running super fast and super reliably. This is insane! I love it, and I use it on a regular basis. Lambda provides you with powerful NVIDIA GPUs to run your own chatbots and experiments. Seriously, try it out now at lambda.ai/papers or click the link in the description.